church, we have this. We have 300 solid spots here. Every single one of these churches is selected by us. And if you've been all along this week in prayer, we can pray together as a worship team. We get some praise of the scripture, the meditation, and prayer. You can tell there's a theme about God's presence. You can tell there's a theme about reaching out to others. This is preparing my heart, our hearts, for the big serve. But we're going to serve the thoughts of the people. We have to be 120 people to do everything we want to do. 120 people. Come on, please. Let's help us out with a good part of that. Right back right after the service in the campaign, we'll come out and provide a position of what we do and how we do it. But never forget, you'll learn this study with a great group of people today. There's 2 weeks from today, we have our annual meeting. That means I'm going to share everything we've got done in the last year. We will also be voting for new leadership team members in certain positions and also judges for the initial discussion in the December. Just 2 weeks from today, we have a lot of Thank you. Thank you. say, Frederick the Great, he has been a blind person. And he was a king that had power to absolve people from prison. So he walked into this prison, all of his prisoners fell to the ground and began to proclaim their innocence. There was one man that Jesus stood. Frederick the Great looked at this man and said, why are you in prison? And he said, I'm robbing you. He said, are you guilty of that crime? Frederick the Great got for a moment and he called the children. He said, gentlemen, I want you to agree with the mission so that he's not corrupted by what it is that he wants to do. His grace tore from wickedness into our lives, swung forward from him. Some of us are so afraid of his death, so afraid of God, because we confess once to someone who did it for us. He had that one-time presence with him. The church leaders, that church family, didn't give us with grace, but they summoned us. Once our mom and our dad, and we told them what we'd done and got involved with, they said, we feel this grace. They said, how could you do this? How could you be so dumb? I raised you together. Why did you do this? He walked away from that mom and said, I will never do real to you again. So this is how it never works. He gets so afraid to confess to God because of your human experience that he keeps you bound up to your prison. When God calls us to the Lord, come to me, you will find my glory, you will find my truth. This is why I said, my God, to call him to see to raise him from the dead, so he can be your perfect mediator to tell us how to live our heart and our life. is a retreat on our work that has been overlapped. Maybe overlapped.
Thanks for watching. If this message helped you, share it with someone you know. And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. If you live in the area, we invite you to join us for one of our worship experiences. Go to CantonNazarene.com for times and more information. Hey, thanks for being a part of our virtual community.